Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to another wonderful, exciting episode of
Tunes Day,
the day we build music from scratch. And today, I guess I want to do like a chill trip hop vibe, and I know what you're thinking. Oh, Slamos, you do lo-fi all the time. This is not going to be lo-fi. This is not. Whereas lo-fi, I consider, here's what you need to have on your track on lo-fi, okay? That makes it lo-fi, okay? You kill that high end, and it's going to be pretty lo-fi. But we're not doing that. We're not doing that today, okay? It's still going to be something chill. I almost wanted to do, there's a composer everyone should look up if you've never heard of him. His name is Steve Reich, R-E-I-C-H. If you don't know what to look up, look for, what's it? It's like music for 13 musicians, or I can't remember how many musicians. It's look Steve Reich music for, and then should finish the rest. It's a certain number of musicians. Oh, it's incredible. I actually need to listen to that again. I haven't listened to that in years. I should do that. That's what I'm going to do tonight. Anyways, music for fireworks is what I heard. You know, if someone were to write a music for fireworks, though, it might be Steve Reich. He did a lot of percussion stuff. He was a drummer, so he would do a lot of weird percussion, or more, when I say weird, it's like unique or rhythmic, unique rhythms. And he did this really interesting piece. Sorry, I'm just going to nerd out on Steve Reich real quick, where he basically put a whole bunch of speakers on the floor. And then he hung microphones. And when they're going straight down, aim at the speaker, it makes feedback, right? Like a microphone would do. Well, he did that, and he hung a whole bunch of microphones on. And then they're like different sizes and different lengths. And he like pulls them back, and then he lets them go. And every time they go over, they go like, you know, as they're getting feedback. And since they're all like different like lengths, they swing in different ways. And it creates a whole bunch of different rhythms that slowly change and evolve as they're... swinging gets slower, and it's so simple, but it's so interesting. A lot of crazy shit like that he's done, so strongly recommend people. Now, that doesn't mean I'm going to start setting up microphones and doing stuff like that. When I say I want to do something Steve Reich inspired, Steve Reich, whatever, however you pronounce his name, I more mean sort of, he would do like a lot of minimalism and a lot of either rhythms or melodies that would change very, very slowly over time. So it works really well for a lot of ambient sort of music, because a lot of that's a lot of slow evolution and shit. So we'll try that. But I'm not doing straight ambientism. We're not going to do like really slow pads that come in. Well, we might in the background, but I want there to be like a looping melody that keeps looping and looping and looping, and other ones come in and come out. Sort of like I did with a guitar one like 4 or so Tuesdays ago. Except I don't have a guitar, so maybe we'll use piano. And I don't even know that we're going to do all that. That's just what I sat down and said, hey, here's an idea. And we'll, of course, yeah, put some zigging and some zagging in. A little bip, a little bop. What is, my splice is just taking forever to open. That's what it is. I do want to start, do I want to start with a drum break, or do I want to just start straight melody? Oh, don't tempt me, splice. Don't tempt me, devil. Oh, good. It removed the temptation. Started off with a fire. Come on, study beats, lo-fi hip-hop. They're calling the packs study beats now. Ooh, okay. A lot of these seem really interesting. Not for the tunes that I want to do right now, but for stuff I want to look at later. So we're going to just do this. We're going to save those ones. This one I could maybe do now. Chords. What does this mean? There's one thing. It's just a bunch of MIDI chords. This wouldn't feel like I wrote it. I can just download this. Here's my Tuesday, guys. Thanks. Thanks for coming to my Tuesday. I did it. I wrote this. Okay, let's get a piano in here. Or, new idea. Before we even get the first one started, let me bring in Helm real quick. I like this idea. Bring in Helm. I said, bring in Helm. Oop. Congrats. Fine accomplishment. I'm world-class producer. World-class produce. Like, I want this to be short as... Okay. I think it's going to be better to arrange this in MIDI. We can keep it at 120, because I really don't know what sort of BPM we want. But let's, let's slap some notes. Here's something cool. Since I don't even know what notes to start on, this is something that everyone should try to find. This app has to still exist. It's called ToneCAD. Have you ever heard of this? It's an app that launches and looks like this. Here, let me do this. How do I clear it? New one. Okay. So there's, of course, an ad for healthcare at the top, so you can ignore that. But it basically is going across and it's playing the notes. It's like a MIDI sequencer sort of thing, right? And I'll just touch anywhere on my phone here. Let me hold it next to the microphone so you can actually hear it. So I can touch around and it'll do that. That's what I just drew, you know? Here, why do I have to have this so small? There it is. But we can draw around. Now I want to get rid of these chords. Change a couple of these around, maybe. You know, I'm just touching around. I like that. Hang on. Is there a way to... There. ToneCAD. I just sort of touched around and I found some melody that I like, right? Hang on, I gotta turn this bitch up. Hang on, I gotta save this real quick. Save it. I gotta figure out what one of these notes is. Is it just a circle of fifths? I should learn how this tone pad is arranged. I think it's just a circle of fifths. Let me try to load that again. I wish there was a way to pause it. It just keeps playing permanently. You have to just, I guess, do new. I guess it's harder than than I anticipated. I guess I've done simpler melodies in the past. Hang on, let me make sure it's the same. Let me do that real quick. Do that. I'm going to try one last stab at this. There used to be, on this thing, a little bit of a graphic showing where it was going. Actually, here, I'm going to do it this way. This is the easiest way I'm going to do it. We're going to figure out the tone pad, right? And it just repeats from there, right? So I can go like this. So this. I assume that's it, right? So let me load up my thing again real quick. And the first note is this that I want to get. So we're going to start on that. And I'm going to just load it out in the same way the sequencer has it. Now I'm going to turn it off. In terms of volume, I'm just going to look at the sequencer on here and try to track it out. Well, that'll work, right? Probably. Let's do this real quick. Okay. So these are, yeah, the viable options. So we start on a B. So let's start it here, and then we're going to shift it all over once we're done. Shrink me down, because I'm not doing so much on here. I'm just going to be looking at my phone. So it goes there, and then it's down. Let's see. One, two, and then the third one. And then it goes... yeah, this should work. We'll hear how it sounds anyways, even if it doesn't work. Then it goes up. Let's see. One, two, three, four. This is just a riveting stream, I bet. One, two, three. And then space, and then down one. And then... immediately back to here, but down to here. And then the starting one. And then one up from the starting one. This key helps so much. I hope I did it right. I think I did. I don't think that sounds right. But I'm gonna keep trudging through. Because I believe. okay. Then starting here, it's two up from the last one. One, two. And then the same as this one. And then up. Oops. And then a space. And then... one below the starting one. And then this whole thing would start two away from the end, right there. That should be it. Now, here's what I want to do real quick. Duplicate this and call this one. Don't touch. So I'll just leave that one alone. So that way we have the tone pad, like, key to work with. Because this might not be totally right. But it might still sound cool. Oh, that doesn't sound good. That doesn't sound good for anybody. So now what I gotta do is delete this. And let's slow it down. We are, like, flying through it still. So let's try one. Let's just do 120. 120 there. Okay. Now, hang on. Stick with me on this. This is how we make it sound more like the app, then. Because they just have an echo with it. Thank you. I like that. I hear a strong rhythm too. All right, start with that. That's a good starting off point, right? Let's build on it. Thanks, Tonepad. I hear the start of the clip actually right here. This feels like the start to me. It doesn't really matter how you hear it. The only context that it matters is that I do something like this then. There. Now it does start like this. So for right now, for writing purposes, loop for days. Hope you guys don't get too sick of this. Let's add some other stuff. I'm gonna add another helm, and I want this to be a long, drawn out one, a little bit. Filter it. Turn it down. Now, hang on. Okay, I was like to say, can I pinpoint the key, sort of? Sounds like outer space, dude. Yeah, man. That's what I'm going for. We're doing space-fi. I wish... Maybe I'm overthinking it. Yeah, I think I am. Here's what I'm gonna have to do. I can't rely on the attack for this. Do like a little bit of one. That's fine. Here's what I gotta do. I'm gonna have to just fade the volume in and out on this bad boy. Just because I want it to change notes at the like peak of the volume, but when I change notes, then that next note starts fading in because of the slow attack. So let's see, it was guess that doesn't need to be. That's just the same one. So it's that long. Wait, is that the right size? That doesn't. Oh, I looped this in a weird way. That's why. Why do I do that? I guess I can do the same for this. Consolidate loop. Okay, here's what I want to do with this. Bring it over here. You open that utility, pop open that gain, turn it all down in general. And then on the gain, nope, gain. Oops. Something like that. Maybe let's do it twice as long. Yeah. Okay, let me just hear this right now. And I guess it doesn't really need to loop. Here's what I want to do. Do that, and then delete that. That's good. That's really good. That's perfect, like ambient background sort of thing. I want to make it bigger too. Here, let me see it go over on the EQ again real quick. I think I want to cut a little bit of low. Yeah, that's the good bits. Okay. What else was I gonna? Oh yeah, I want to put a reverb on this thing maybe. Oh, let's just try a normal house reverb. That's pretty good. Something relatively big. I don't want to use the normal cathedral if possible. Bright long verb. Nah, that's a pretty lame one. All right, we're at least going to hall. Hang on, what would cathedral sound like? I use cathedral all the time. It sounds pretty nice. I think it sounds pretty nice. I'll try it, why the hell not? It's actually not bad. It's very subtle. Okay. That's our bass. I'm good at labels. That wouldn't be confusing at all. Yo, turn up the bass. I want to do this actually. Let's duplicate this bass. And I would like to change the loop two, three. And I would like to reset this entirely. Oh, but hang on. Oh, let's do this. This is a good way to do it. We'll call this one variation. It's not really going to be a variation. It's going to be more of a layer, but whatever. Pop this back open. Here's our chart to work with. I'm going to just make a new one right now that should hopefully work with it. I wish there was a way you could mute certain... Oh, there is sort of. I could do this. Yeah, these notes. What if I did this? Oh, it doesn't care or listen to that sort of stuff. Never mind. Or, okay. Here we go. Wait. Why use Live 9? Because I'm a po' boy. Who doesn't have 10? Or the money to upgrade, at least. Someday. And also because 9 still gets the job done. I don't know. Does pretty good. What were these other ones at? 100, I think? I don't know. I don't think it even matters. It's not even listening to the velocity. Let's pick a few around here. I'm going to do the same with the tone pad idea. I'm just going to click random. Put some gaps in. More space. But also simpler. Like, maybe higher. Okay, some of these work. I sort of like this more. This is more something that I'm going to add in like later for like a little bit of flavor. We can also give that extra variation feel by doing something like this. I mean, it's already going to be a different echo, so it should already stand out. Actually, maybe we don't even need that. It did stand out pretty well there. I might actually want to change the echo too. It almost sounds like picking up a Mario coin or something. Super Nintendo. Mario World. It's not quite doing what I was hoping. I think I need to change the sound more. Also the notes. What was this at? 60%. Actually, which country are you from? I'm from the United States of America. That's what I thought. I'm just spacing them out too much. Do you like Trump? Hell no. I don't think anyone does. And I know that you say somebody does, but trust me, it's a very small minority. This is what I need to do with all of these, is consolidate them this small. Oh, never mind. It just deleted those notes because they weren't used. Never mind. My big brain idea was not so big brain idea. So we'll bring that in a little bit. That's what we do. I mean, I think if we're talking about the beginning of this whole song, actually, we should just do this. I don't know. Fade in. That's what I was going to do, reflexively. Maybe there's a cooler way to do it. I've done a lot of like EQ transitions in. I haven't done anything with an auto pan. Can I do something fucking? Oops. Nah, I don't know that I can do any cool. I can use the auto pan as a layer with it, but not as the primary thing that makes it sound cool. I've used grain delay a lot. I could do that too. You know, we do something like. Love this. Hang on. Can I get it a nice even 12? Duplicate it. And this one, turn it off. Sounds like Kraftwerk intro. Kraftwerk. Why does that sound so familiar? Kraftwerk intro. Oh, I know them. I love this photo of them on stage. They were big in the 80s, right? Man, to see a show like that would be a trip. Huh. Yeah, I agree. It does sound like something they would do then. Oh. So, okay. Let's actually bring in that part later. I like this. They look like what Blue Man Group would hate, right? We need to have a celebrity deathmatch with Blue Man Group and Kraftwerk. Okay, hang on. This variation doesn't work so well with this other sample. This works really well with this part. So we gotta save those for later. I'm gonna have this just keep going. We're gonna have this loop for a little bit. Paste it in the right spot. I don't know if it got moved or not, whatever, who cares? It sounds way better like that. Keep it there. Yeah, okay. So we'll get to those ones later. We still got this early part. Let me add... I want to add a piano real quick. Actually, I want to add a piano, but I want to do something to that piano. First, I want a shitty sounding piano. Don't I have, it's a clav saxophone, four front piano. Yeah. This plugin has no settings. That's how dirty this one is. It's not a very good sounding piano, is it? Let's see if I still remember how to play this. Nope, can't play that anymore. I'm just failing horribly at it. Okay, never mind. Let's get back to work. Let's get back to work. Stop failing. We're not playing ragtime. Okay, hang on. I like this transition, but let me actually just do just the B for a few of them. What if we hold on? It just is the B that comes in and fades, and then this one comes in later when it does that. We'll save that for later. I still want to do some stuff to this piano too. I don't want it quite as clean as it sounds right now. I want to do this sort of thing for the melody. Yeah, that's the note I want. I love that. Just like to have that sort of droning melody going over the background. It's good. It's good. I love it. I want to do some stuff to the piano because I'm aware that it sort of sounds like shit. But it's the right kind of shit for me. Making them a little bit off to make it feel more real. These are just subtle things that I feel like not enough producers will do. Sort of, I don't know, it's honestly so subtle Oops, except for that one. That one's not subtle at all. But no one who's playing is ever really going to hit it perfectly at the same time. But if you do it that, you're never going to hear it live. It's going to sound like someone pressed it and not punched it in to a keyboard. Or into a computer, I mean. Okay. First off, okay, good. We do have it sent into the reverb. Now, what do I want to do first to it? I could always do my classic, this. But we're not making lo-fi today, I swear. It doesn't feel like it's in the right spot. Hang on. I know it technically is, according to Ableton. But with the rhythm of it, it just doesn't feel right. Hang on, hang on. Beep, boop, boop. Have you ever used Tel Vocorder? Ooh, I think that's the right spot now. I don't think so. Vintage vocoder emulation with 11 bands and emulates the sounds of... I have to try that. Thanks for the heads up. I do use the Ableton vocoder every now and then. As well as I do have... I'm plugged into the Roland VT3 right now.
So I can do this stuff, yeah. I can do this stuff, yeah.
So that's fun.
Affirmative. I will say whatever you need me to, Lead Sniper.
What's funny is I don't have a headphone preview, so I know what it sounds like or what it's supposed to sound like, but I don't actually know that it's on or working. I'm just pretty sure it is. This is good. Let me do more stuff to this. Hang on. I gotta be careful that I don't leave the robot effect on, because I've done that before. There's one time that I put reverb on as a joke, and then I just did the rest of my screen for like 15 minutes like this. And I didn't even realize it was up. That was bad.
Dear Mother, I'm writing to let you know that I have passed in the war. I'm going to heaven. God bless you and baby Jimmy. Lead Sniper 7. Seven.
How was that? Here's something I can do. Did I ever save this? It would be. Mario. No, I don't think I ever saved this. Okay. I want to do a Redux, but a Redux doesn't have a dry wet, which I need. So I forget how I did this. So I'm going to just press buttons till I figure it out. Oh, I remember how. I duplicate this. And on one of these chains, I delete that. So I call this one clean. Right? Am I doing this right? And this will have, like, I don't know. That sounds good. We'll say it's that. And then I'm like 99% of the way there. Hang on. And then I map this macro to I feel stupid when I'm so close. Damn, I used to know how to make these. It's a really simple thing for a dry wet. Is it this? Here it is. Map to, there it is. The chain selector, I found it. It's this little yellow bar right there. So what I do with this, now I can call this one dry wet. Is it switching? There, that's perfect. Now, why this doesn't come already on the effect, I don't know. Call this one crush. Why you have to make your own like this beats me, but that's how you can do it. Bit crush. Actually, what I should just do is just save this as bit crush and then just be like, do this. Map to macro 2. Rename, call this one down sample. Cool, doesn't fit. Set it to what was it before? It was 13. And set this one to wait, whoops. Soft, hard. Soft, hard. There. Yeah, see, I just went in a little bit of crunch in the background. There, see, what I gotta just save is this. This is the new BitCrush pedal. There, pedal, preset, effect. Now it feels off. It's weird how I hear it different now. I still think the piano is coming in too loud and thumpy. I can do more to it. Still doesn't feel right. What if I did this? Lower the velocity a ton and just jack up the volume. And take that off. I think I might need to change piano effects. Yeah, that's the problem. That's why it sounds so big, is because, it's just the piano sample. Like I said, I was shitty and it was going to make it sound shittier, but the dude didn't record different playing volumes. So that way, like, if you're hitting really hard versus if you're hitting sort of soft, it's always going to sound different. And that dude just hit it really hard and he's like, oh, when it's soft, just lower the volume. But that's not the same. It doesn't sound the same. And a ripping drum solo as a tribute to Neil Peart. Yeah, that's true. I'd do a Rush-themed one, but I feel like that would take me, like, over 60 hours to write a Rush song. I don't know. That would take a lot of doing. Relative Minor, what's going on? Thank you for those 5 bits. How are you doing? How come this one didn't get heard, like, at all? What? turn down the dry wet a little here on this. Hang on a minute. I just finished jamming in Ableton, actually. Really? Never mind. I'm just amazed at just such a small amount on here. So loud still. What'd you make in Ableton? Maybe this note needs to change. Made a set called Riffs, and it is a basic drum, bass, guitar to record ideas. Oh, nice. Like sort of like a nice easy template you can start off. Just for when you've got riffs that you just want to get in. I want to add. I feel like I want to add some sort of percussion, but I don't want it to necessarily be the same classic, you know, drum kit sort of stuff. Don't I have like a electronic drum sort of thing, or electric hi-hat? Let me go with that. I probably got more in here somewhere. Moog drum kit, yeah. Put that one in too. I do still want to mess with the piano a little bit. In fact, if I increase the dry wet, but put that on. Could be good. It's still not doing quite what I wanted it to do. Maybe it's not a piano. I don't know. That one's iffy. I gotta figure it out. I like the notes. Because now that feels like the right spot. It keeps changing depending on what I hear in the loop. Because now this feels like it's a perfect loop. Thank you. All right, I'm gonna loop this. Actually, I should. We'll leave it there and hope that starts sounding consistently good. I mean, it sounds good right now. Ooh, that's loud. Hang on. Stick with me for just a sec. I know it sounds weird, right? That's not right. That's right. Okay, loop that. Now let's move them around. This is how we can find other rhythms. Let's try this. Oh, hang on, that's the same. Shit, hang on, it's just, god damn it, damn you, Ableton. It's because it's, hang on, let me, forgot to mention my riffs project. I'm recording to session view now. Oh really? Oh, thank you for even more bits. I appreciate it. I need to do this. I think I need to freeze this bass track. Let me do this like foundation one here, just so it's always consistent, because the way that I keep hearing it is always a little different depending on what gets looped where. So I want to freeze it and see if it's just my ears or if Ableton is changing it. See, like right now I hear it differently. I hear it in a different spot. Let me. Let me try this real quick. I'm going to unfreeze it. I know this might be the work of a madman. Wait. Unfreeze it. And then I go doop doop. And then I freeze it again. I want you to work, bitch. Don't just be like, I already did that. I know what it sounds like. No. Do it again. Okay, sounds exactly the same. Just wondering, because whenever there's loops and stuff, I don't know, I feel like sometimes it can be funny. Actually, it does sound a little different now. Unless I'm crazy. Now it sounds like that's where it should be. Hang on.
Mm-hmm.
fuck. The rhythm is wherever you hear it in your head. That's a place I've been before. I think that's where it might have to go. Okay, here's the problem. Some weird echo every now and then. You better work, bitch. It's Britney Spears. That's true. That song she wrote is amazing. I always wanted, I said that too. I want to do a Toonsday someday that's in that vein of that Britney Spears song. The one where she's like, you better work, bitch. You better work it, bitch. And I just want to make a song that's just like, do it, fucker. And it'll just be like, you know, grinding on one note, thumping, do it, fucker. Someday. I support this.
Yeah.
I think that'd be funny. Do it, fucker. I could just hear it already. Rattling the walls of the clubs. Perfect place for a firework. No. No. There. Let's go. I want to get weird with these rhythms. I want to try something. This might be weird, but it might work.
Thank you.
Oh, no, I see. It's waiting. It skips a beat there. Never mind. It's not off. You hear those extra notes there? I wanted to do this. Let's hear how this sounds. I'm basically taking this rhythm that I came up with and I'm moving it off one beat every single time. I don't know where those extra little notes come in. Every now and then you hear those. There's like tiny little extra notes that keep slipping in. I have no idea what those are, and my cat's starting to scream too. I mean, I was going to add some stuff that can add some little extra notes like this. I think this would sound really cool. On what track? On this, on the hi-hat. Right there. Did you hear that? Going over this part, these notes were still played even though there's nothing there. This is the whole thing. I'm trying to scroll up and down. There's nothing else there. It's not always the same. Right there. You see that? Played at a slow-ass tempo. See if it does it in the same spot again. You see that? It did do it. Hang on. Is there something? Is there like a really tiny note there? Did you hear it? It played. I'm not crazy. It did. Here, starting from the beginning, right here. It didn't do it that time. But you heard it the first time, right? Oh, come on. See, that's what I mean. It doesn't do it every time. That's what makes me think it's not an effect or something weird. It's some sort of glitch. It's because it doesn't do it every time. It just sometimes does it. But why? I turned this off, so that's not going. Wait, where's the sample? Hang on. Is the sample warped? Wait. What is this? Is there a decay? There's no loop or nothing on there. Oh boy, we slowed it down too much. What were we at before? 120? I think it was 120. I think I gotta open this door too for my cat. Go into the sample. I don't know if this one will let me because it's, I don't know where I got this one from. Hang on a second. Hang on just a second. Ugh. That's the bull. Hi. All right. Just had to open the door. I let my cat in. She's screaming at the door. Wants to come in and scream for you guys. Okay, go in the sample. I don't think I can. I don't know where I got this one or where I arranged this hi-hat thing, because some of them you see they have the normal sample. Some of them don't. I think that means I pulled them from an Ableton pack and put them in here. And so it doesn't show stuff. Yeah. I don't know. It's okay. I really want just the high bits. Just the really light little blitz. See, the little extra notes that it's playing to don't even really matter that much to me, just because with this delay on there, it sort of looks like this. This is a great description there, Ableton. You don't see the tiny little rhythmic details that I did. It just is sort of a sound since it's being ping-pong delayed. But I didn't want to have it just straight every single time, because then it would be very obvious that it's being looped and all that sort of stuff. The sort of difference in the movement in it every time is what makes it sort of unpredictable and interesting. It makes it less of a steady rhythm that you just tap your toe to, and more of just an interesting percussion. Now, how do I want to start this still? My cat's just sitting on the floor going, meow, meow, meow. Real quietly. Hey. Oh, here she comes. Any day now. Come on. I got writing to do. Where'd you go? Sorry, I know this is riveting. Man searches for cat off stream. No. Yeah, right there. Yeah, go straight up. Yep. I'm watching your head. There we go. She did it, ladies and gentlemen. She's landed. The thing is, I don't want to unfreeze this bass track because it sounds nice. But I can't move it now, can I? Oh, I can. I can move it. Hang on a second. Can I still automate volume and stuff? No. I could just move it. Sorry, my cat is demanding my attention right this instant. Okay, so if I can move it... We could start with something like this. What if we did this? No, I'm gonna have to just unfreeze it. I think I can do some cool stuff with this still, though. I could do something like this. Let me try unfreezing it. I can always freeze it again, and maybe we'll get something good. I'm going to put the camera back up. You can't see my cat. She's just quietly chilling. Hopefully it stays like that. Let me do something vocoder. Dry, wet. Okay, what if I did this? Duplicate this, bring it up to here, rename this one. Cat's leaving. I'm gonna call this one Ghost Fade and turn it off. Now, I want you to, listen to Ghost Fade and delete this one. How does this sound? That's good. That's a good start. Let's do some more automation stuff at the beginning here to make it more interesting. Like something like this, maybe. Oh, this is the wrong pad, isn't it? Or no? No, yes, it is. Put an EQ on it. I want to look at these waveforms here. And they're just sine waves, so it's real plain. You know, something that might sound interesting. Whoops. It's fucking with one of these. Thank you. What if we started here? Sort of like that. That sounds interesting. Freeze. Oh no. What if we froze both of them? Fuck you. Fine. That sounds amazing. I love that. Boom 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 boom. All right, I got the piano in the right spot now too. Need to be pushed back a little bit. They're so close together. We're going to do this. Doesn't even matter which ones I do. It's probably going to sound cool no matter what. As long as it's sort of consistent. Or sort of even, I guess. Guess to get the accurate sound with the loop, you always have to start it from the beginning. Start over real quick. Man, I have to be very careful not to touch this intro. I love how this intro part sounds. Oh, Wait, what if we tried that right away again? Let me start from the beginning, because it doesn't loop right unless you start it from the beginning. I'm having second thoughts about the piano. Let me, I'm gonna get rid of the piano. I don't like it anymore. Bad. I think this needs to be lost in more reverb. I gotta keep starting it from the beginning so I can make sure that all the stuff is going correctly through the loop. It's actually extremely tedious. But I don't know how to maintain that intro. without forcing myself to do that. Because it won't let me freeze the track because there's a vocoder going. Downbeat. Feels there if that is true, my thing is wrong. Say it in robot voice.
My thing is wrong.
It's wrong. Save the hi-hat. I want to do something. But hang on. Let me find it first. Let's do this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Boom. Consolidate. Open this bitch up. Give me something kicky. Oh! Sorry about that. Okay. Let's open for something quick. Hang on, I think I have a kit that's better than that. There's a specific sort of sound I want to get real quick. Will you get sued by Michael Jackson if you sing the Happy Birthday song in the robot voice? He doesn't own that anymore, does he? I'm pretty sure that copyright expired a few years ago. So I'm pretty sure that's fair game for anybody. If anyone wants to do some dope remixes of the Happy Birthday song, I'm pretty sure it is now public domain. I know it wasn't for a long time, but I think it was like 3 or 4 years ago. It got dropped off. I'm sort of looking for that. All right, now I'm going to place this where I feel the downbeat. And this will help us. Because, yeah, that's always consistent, at least. Stick with me a sec. I love that my cat, she crawls outside my door, throws a shit fit for me to open up the door. I do. Climbs into my lap for about 5 seconds, leaves, takes a shit, because I could hear it and smell it, and then just goes right back to sleep. The wonderful life of a cat. Just scream for a little attention, get it, go take a shit and fall asleep. Fuck you, day well spent. Hang on a minute. That doesn't sound right now. These loops, working with this shit is gonna drive me nuts. Wish I could freeze the fucking track. Now the beat's off. There. This is driving me nuts. Now that feels like it's on the beat, right? That feels like it's flawlessly on the beat. Let's start over. Like, if we have to start on a weird downbeat, that's fine. But it has to be the same downbeat every time I hit play, or this song's not going to be writable. No. Okay. Can't create a kick that comes in unless okay, what if we did this? Let me go into here real quick, and I'm going to turn off the vocoder. The vocoder's nice. Well, what do I do? What do I do? Because it's different every time then. What if I have an idea? I have an idea. I have an idea. This will work. Watch this. I'm going to take this vocoder and I'm going to throw it onto a bus. Sometimes music producing is a lot like a lot like programming, where you know there's an answer or a solution. You just have to think of a weird way to do it. Where right now I need to be able to freeze these tracks, but I can't with this vocoder on it. So if I delete the vocoder from the track, it's just this one. That's the only one I need. And then I send it 100%. Where is the vocoder? It's the one base here. To the vocoder one. And I say send only. Therefore, it is sending it to that, which has got the same automation and everything. Now I should be able to freeze this track. And it should be the same every single time now. I think. Was the one I had? I already forgot which one I had on there. Hang on. It's really important to me that I know. Oops, don't do that. Let me go on here and get rid of this. Because I can't tell with that EQ on there. That one. That was the one I used. Okay, now play from the beginning. This is the true test. Should still match up with the kick. Ghost Fade isn't even used anymore at that point. Okay. We got a good start going here. Only 2 hours in. Actually, though, this turns into like almost a whole song. As you can see, by the time we are already more fleshed out with the drums, we're almost 2 minutes in. I guess my title's not totally right. This isn't really a trip-hop song. It's turned into more of an ambient song. I still have these to work with, too. Which are the original samples that I had. I just pitched this down an octave and was like, yep. I want to do that. Actually, I want to fade it in with... I'm going to do this. Stop. What the fuck? Just delete it. Stop. Oh my god. Why do I feel like I'm fighting Ableton so much right now? Why? How many dots are there? Go away. All of this. Go away. Go away. Okay. I just wanted to fade in with the other stuff. Okay, right here. During that fade, I want to fade in. I want to fade in a bass. That's what I want. Sorry. I just sort of sat in thought on that comment. All right, I just want to bring in this bass. Let's do this. Copy over this utility. Okay, I don't think I actually need the kick. But I like the bass. Let me try this. I'm going to copy the utility for the fade, the one that sort of goes in and out. I like the idea of the bass coming in with the hi-hat, though, too. So, like, nothing on this one. No. How do you feel about the bass fades? Like the bass fading in like this. And then doing note change. And then fading out. I kind of like it. Let's go with that. Let's see. Whoops. That sounds good. Yeah, that sounds really good.
Decibel.
Oh, my cat's back. She's gonna start screaming. All right. Let's hear this from the beginning. There's a bomb. I want this to be a slower evolution. Fade that in. I like that. Also, this should fade in too, I think. Or I don't know. This might sound better just coming in right away. Yeah, I like that actually. Oh, that sounds so good. Oh, I was like, oh, I need to automate the volume of that a little bit. I want it to fade out. No, I'm going to have to unfreeze the track. No. Mm-mm. No siree babaroo. In fact, I could just automate this. I'll just put a utility on. Or no. No. I'll just automate this. Do this. Speaker on track volume. Oh, my cat. Throwing a fit. Okay. Decibel. Being a brat. Thank you. That's a good start. Let's hear what we got. It's 3 minutes in. I think I want to change the fade part for the strings. I want to change a couple of these. Oh, strings not right away, too. Strings come in later. Strings would come in approximately right there. Something more might need to still happen there. Dez! Hey! Cat is just being a rambunctious little asshole right now. Oh, it's because it's 420. She wants to blaze it. No! You can't blaze it! You're a cat. Stupid cats. Cats can have a little blaze it as a treat. Oh, the more you know. You hear that, Dez? You can blaze it a little. Okay, hang on. I almost want to start adding some woodwinds and stuff too. We might do that. Sorry, didn't know my computer was going to jump scare me like that. Okay. What the fuck? Thanks, computer. Turn those down a lot. Yeah, this sounds awesome. This is very, very cinematic. A definite difference from the last Tuesday I did, which was very just, I don't know, pretty pop rocky. So horns on this one. Go double it at the octave. Okay. It's funny how I feel like I went an hour and a half, and when I looked at the clock and I looked at what I had, it was like nothing. Barely anything even started. And now I look two and a half hours in, so just 1 hour more. And technically, I could call this a finished song if I really wanted to be done. It's long enough. It is interesting enough. But I do think I want to add a little more still. I think there needs to be something still here. Because I'll tell you when I'm bored. This part I'm not. Because I'm like, ooh, what was that synth and that bass? Interesting. And you hear it come in again. And you hear that the bass is different this time. Ooh, still interesting. Because I haven't heard that bass before. And now it repeats. And this is where something new would come in. And the hi-hat does come in, but very slowly. So I don't necessarily know that I like how slow, or it being just the hi-hat that comes in. You know? For instance, once we get to the next part, the strings come in, but also that little background variation loop. So I think I need to come up with something else that still comes in right here. I don't know what it's going to be yet. I have an idea. I'll do it in just a second. And then this stuff comes in here. It's interesting enough. The strings are really nice. Then the addition of woodwinds is good. I'm gonna put that on the woodwinds as well. Kind of like that weird C sharp that we go to. Match this fade out a little bit. Actually, no. Better idea. We're gonna sort of change the sound. Let me bring in an EQ. So we can see it's pretty much just the high end, right? So none of this even really matters. Oh, God. My cat just scared the fuck out of me. I don't know if you could hear that, but she started itching. And then she had her foot right next to the wall. So it sounded like someone was knocking on the wall. Like that. And it scared the fuck out of me. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. My walls are knocking at me. Ooh. I don't know. Did you hear that knocking sound? That was my kitty knocking on the wall to scare the fuck out of me. Okay, here's what I'm going to do. Let's do this. Turn that off. Go here. Start recording. We're going to need a delicate hand for this one. There. So the hi-hat did fade out, but in a different way. Just is a little different. Here come the zigzags. No, see, that's the secret all along. Look at this. Watch this. You see this right here? Hidden in plain sight, son. Oh, and what's this? Oh my goodness. It's infected them all. You see, the zigzag was in your heart all along, Leet Sniper. was there all along. So I still got to add the part here. And I was originally thinking that I would have this stuff go into this. The sordidness, right? I mean, everything fades out to just these two background sounds that are looping. And then I would go into them and I would open them up. So like open this up, pull this down. Same with this, same thing on it.
And we would go from there.
And I'd sort of almost, not really write a new song, but sort of think of it in that way. Like, okay, this was the really long 2.5 minute intro. Now here's the actual song. That said, I sort of like this more than what I had before. I almost want to keep that as the ending. So, like, maybe we will have this sort of shorter in terms of, like, an ambient track. I guess this is still... It'll still be, like, a 3.5 minute track, maybe, in the end. But in terms of ambience, that's pretty short, I think.
But it's Steve Reich ambient, so...
It's got more rhythm to it. Let's focus first off on whatever the sound is that I'm adding right here. Oh, here, let me do this first. This was one of the sounds that I wanted to add. Dragging an instrument rack. And I'm not sure which one I want exactly. So let's find out. Vocals. I have 111 vocal samples already. Give me like an ooh or an ah or... Oh, you're a little loud there. Really? That's a pixel from quiet? Can't go any quieter than that. Why are these crackling so much? You hear how much they're crackling? I just wanna feel good. I mean, as long... I still love you. They're not gonna crackle in the... Hey, yo, pop that pussy. I'm about to get some waffles at the Waffle House. I bought these. Motherfucker. I paid for those. I don't think I did that one. That's a good one. Toasty. Tons of reverb.
Thank you.
All right, I think I might have something. Yeah, I hear a lot of potential with this. Try something real quick. What if I grabbed all of this and moved it one right there? Same with the bass. Thank you. Hang on, let me try something real quick. The first time I had this originally coming in, I started up on an A. Nah, I take that back. I like the F sharp, actually. So we got our addition. Actually, let's do this. Loop. All right, actually, start from the beginning. Notice that. Do a regular mob if you prefer instead of the Illuminati. That's true. We should bring back old school mobsters. It's the 20s again, right? It's the 2020s this time. Extra reverb on it? Yeah, I'm gonna need more. Turned up too. What that was. I'm gonna have a look into that. That was a weird sound. Ah, that's what's happening. I love it. So what's happening is the volume fades out and then it shoots back up instantly. Instantaneously. How do I capture and replicate that? I could freeze and then flatten the tracks, and then I would have that. That's one way. See right here. I like that extra little hi-hat that comes in. It's interesting. I guess that would be like 3 minutes long right there if I cut it that short. I'm okay with it being that short if everything does as it should. This is a bad idea. Hang on. Cancel. Here's what I want to do. Group the tracks. Duplicate the group. Turn this one off and this one. Everybody. Where's freeze? Freeze. So now I have the original saved, just in case I need to make any changes, or because this freeze flatten thing that I'm doing right now should really be the last step, at least in these tracks. So we're getting, I think, near the end of the song, so that's why I'm doing them now. Okay, so I froze it, then I flatten it, and that'll basically just turn all of this into actual live audio instead of MIDI. There you go. Why does this one have that weird dip? You know? Why are they all the same except that one? That's what I want. So I'm going to take this right there, consolidate it, and loop them. Now, this is looping with it too. Cool. I want to do a little more to it. Let's look at this part. Okay, yeah, let's do that. Let me try that. Actually, can I just do this? I just put it on the whole group. Doi. Go for about that long. Yeah, no, that needs to go. I want to increase the resonance on that one. No, I just this. Just this. Okay, what if I did this? That. No, then it's going to delete all the automation, actually. Can't do that. This is the downside to drawing it yourself. I don't think a utility is going to do enough. I think I'm going to have to do this, which is a bummer, but I guess it acts as a whole. The whole entire group mix volume go down. Because, well, you can still hear it a little bit, and the utility can only go to negative 35. Unless you have the new Ableton, then I know utility can go to negative infinity, which is something I'm looking forward to. But I ain't got the new Ableton, so we work with what we got. One last thing. On this, add a really severe feedback part. right here. There. Because then that'll just keep looping. And, or just sort of echo for a while. Though maybe it's two. Too long? Just not a 95. We'll go to 80 something. Hang on just a second. I need to use groups more. I seriously don't use it enough. It's so handy. It's funny because I used to use Logic Pro before I switched to Ableton. And Logic Pro, it's all about buses, which this does have. It's got these. And at first I was like, how do you only survive off two buses? And you can create your own, or I think it's, yeah, here we go. Create a return track. Yeah, there we go. So you can have unlimited buses, but it just seemed weird to me coming off of Logic. But I understand now, when they have groups, how groups are sort of like a different form of a bus, almost. A little bit. They're a little more user-friendly in terms of your viewing, in my opinion. Well, this definitely could work for a film trailer. I think this is better shorter, too. Because it is a loop that doesn't change a lot, which I'm fine with. Because it's sort of a slow evolution song. But it can't go for too long. This would work really well for an intro track, honestly. Like, this is the hype track to an album. And then it's done right there. 3 minutes and 2 seconds. We'll just keep that as it is. Yeah, that isn't trip hop at all. My title's a total lie today. This became like true ambient cinematic, but you know what? I'm okay with it. I like it. It's biggest, most important thing to me is it's different. I like a good different. Every now and then. I guess this is rather important. I didn't do any headphone mixing. I didn't once listen to this with headphones. I need to go get my headphones. I can't call this done until I do some headphone mixing. Hang on a second. I will be right back. Thank you.
All right, headphone mixing time.
Yeah, I can already hear. Doing like a fake doubling effect on that pad. This sounds awful with headphones on. What up, Captain Skizzy? Welcome. How are you doing? Yeah, this is like a hype track. These thankfully have some good spatialness to it because of the ping pong delay. Same with this one, I suppose. Yeah. Because the ping pong delay is just basically bouncing it left and right through your ear. So those are fine. The hi-hat, I even put a ping pong delay on that to give it that, you know, sort of all around feel, which I get from the hi-hat. I can hear it bouncing between my left and right ear a bunch. Hear this from the beginning again. I think I got enough spatialization. It's not too mono. I love this intro. I think that intro is fantastic. Yeah, so I gave this pad a little bit more of space. Didn't touch the bass, not gonna. We'll hear if the vocals are too loud again. They were way too loud before. I want them to fade in more. Doesn't have to be that big of a fade in, something like this, maybe. Yeah. That might be perfect right there, actually. I need to turn my sound effects down. That's so loud. Was that super loud for everybody else? I think my track is really quiet too. Oh, thank you so much for the follow though. Telling Tales Musics. Yeah, a little, okay. I think my track is just, okay, hang on. Here's what we're going to do. Here's what we're going to do real quick. Everyone just turn your volume down a little. Just turn your volume down. I'm not going to be louder. My track's just going to be louder. So sorry if you don't hear me now. My track is just so quiet. So we'll make it a little louder. Can't hear shit, but I thought it was just your laptop speakers. I think my track's just too quiet. Look at this, I'm boosting at 8 dB right here, and we're not even getting a red line. And now you can hear it. Sounds like in love with a ghost. And I kind of look like him. I don't even know what that is. In love with a ghost. Surprise, I am him. Them. Uh-oh. Oh. In love with... I do sort of look like him. Oi. Motherfucker's biting my style. I love this aesthetic here. That's good. I love that this is the only pic of him, too. Oh, never mind. His net worth. How have I never heard of this person that he's Googling net worths? French musician. Okay. Interesting. Okay, wait. Let me go back over here. When we first jump back like that, I don't like that. Too loud. Please lower volume. Thank you. Bye. Okay, that's good, but not that low, I guess. You're exaggerating what I meant, Ableton. I'm aware I drew the line. I can still make it Ableton's fault. Okay, that. Okay. Here from the beginning again. The vocals coming in right there. Hang on. What if I said vocals? Listen to that. Fuck you. Fine. I don't like any of those. I don't want to do the ghost fade. I feel like it's not going to sound good. You're not even going to hear it at the beginning. I want to do something more to it. What more do I do to it, though? I like the fifth. Thank you.
How cute is that?
Good morning, everyone. Wake up! Boy, am I glad I already turned up the volume on my track. Can you imagine if I didn't and then that came on? Ooh, that would have blown all your holes out. That was already too loud. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to do this right now. Streamlabs. Oh, suck a dick. Is it gonna make me do this stuff? Hang on. Sorry. I'll play some music. Fuck off. Oh my god, I haven't been on Streamlabs website in a while. It fucking sucks. It's so bad. Oh, what is this new interface? Ugh, it's a mess. Alright, let's find this shit. How do I just do general volume? Is there just a general settings? Alert delay, layout, profanity filter. Do I gotta do it individual? Fuck you. Oh my god. Let's go like the. That was 60 something. Let's go 38. Here's what's annoying. Okay, well, what? I changed it. Oh, there we go. Never mind. I have to do this for all of them. What's more is I have variations. Look at this. So every month is different. And you bet it plays a different volume. That was already 40%? Wait a minute. Oh no. I don't think I can do these all right now. That was already 40%. We're not going to do that now. Let me just do the bits real quick. The bits are real quiet already. Whatever. Well, what happened to the... What just happened there? Hang on a minute. Why did a bunch of this shit drop off? Whatever, let's finish this track. My alerts are not your concern. I'll deal with that later. Let's just finish this. We're almost done. It doesn't sound right to me. Thank you. Why don't I hear this right anymore? Maybe birth it from reverb. This is why I did not want to automate this part. Actually, no, we're just gonna do this though. Take the easy way. That's a bad perspective. Let's go back here a little bit more. Thank you. I like it. I think that might be the finished track. Yeah. It's not bad. And like I said before, too, most important, it's different, which I like that a lot. I don't know if I said this before or not, but thank you, Captain Skizzy, for that Twitch Prime sub. Really appreciate it. And reminding me that my alerts are too loud and I need to turn them the fuck down. Today was an all right stream. I guess I apologize for the failure in terms of audio leveling. Not something that's good for a music guy. Yeeks. But at least you could still hear it. And I've had worse streams in terms of audio. So hey, it's not that bad, right? Yeah, probably. Whatever. Anyways, thanks for watching. Thanks for hanging out. I will mix and master this one, put it up online, and you can enjoy it as many times as you would like. Next stream, I don't know when the next stream is going to be. I'm still trying to work on getting Mario Maker up going again, but I got to figure out something with swapping my TVs. But basically a whole lot of my problem, not your problem. So let me figure that out, and I'll let you know when those are going to be live again. But otherwise, I will always, of course, be here on Tuesday to write you a brand new piece of music, and who knows what next week will be. Thanks for watching. Thanks for hanging out. Once again, thanks, Captain Skizzy, for that Twitch Prime sub. Thanks, Telling Tales Music, for the follow. And just hanging out, of course, along with everybody else for hanging out. Thanks for Relative Minor for those 15 bits. And then otherwise, everybody. I don't know, Elite Sniper, Chaz, Polvorde. Though I don't know if you're still here. But if you are, thanks for watching. Thanks for hanging out. I'll see you all later. Bye-bye. Thank you.